But first, I'm not going to be as generous as Peter Credlin just was. I'm not, because I warned Peter Dutton from the get-go last year, do not make Julian Leeser your shadow minister for The Voice. This will end in tears, and today it did. Leeser's also the opposition's shadow attorney general. Today quit those jobs so he could campaign as a backbencher for Labor's Voice, just 1 week after he said he was against it.
I believe the time for The Voice has come. I believe in local and regional voices. I believe in a national voice drawn from local and regional bodies. And I will support the referendum being put this year.
Now, Leeser's performance today should now prove something very clear to opposition leader Dutton and his party. The way you are fighting this voice, kind of Aboriginal-only advisory parliament, written into our constitution, it does not work. And it is time to man up or die. Until today, the Liberals have had a timid, half-pregnant, apologetic strategy for saying no to Labor's Voice to Parliament. Don't fight it in principle. No. Don't say it's fundamentally wrong to divide Australians by race and give one race extra political rights under our constitution. Let's just fight the voice instead by quibbling about the details. But how will it actually work? Should the wording be a bit different? Could the courts one day maybe give the voice too much teeth? And no matter how many times I try to get Peter Dutton to fight the voice on moral grounds, he refused, as you've seen on this show. But I want to come back to that question again. Forget the details. This is about fundamental principle. A Labor plan to divide Australians by race and giving one side, one race, different political rights to another. As a Liberal, dedicated to everyone being equal before the law, how can you possibly even think about agreeing to something like that? It is not about details, it's about a fundamental principle.
Well, Andrew, for my position, I've been very upfront and honest in relation to my approach. That is that we're going through a discussion now. We're going through trying to obtain all of the detail from the Prime Minister and from the government, and the onus is on the Prime Minister to provide that detail.
And that was entirely the Julian Leeser strategy, the one that he himself today proved was completely useless. You see, Leeser has worked for The Voice for years. How could he now admit that it was racist at heart? So last week, right, he went to the National Press Club in Canberra and said the Liberals were against The Voice because, there you go again, you know, the details, the missing details, sloppy wording and the Labor drafting that could make The Voice too powerful, able to make every federal public servant jump.
First, who can The Voice talk to? Which agencies are in and which are out when it comes to being part of the executive government? Second, what can it talk about? In other words, what are matters relating to Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander peoples? Third, what does it mean to make representations? Does it imply or leave room for any reciprocal constitutional obligation on Parliament or the executive?
Now, sure, they're all great questions, but today Leeser proved that for him, even those arguments that he was making right there don't convince him. They're not deal breakers at all, not for him. No matter how dangerous the voice is, no matter how little we know about how it's going to work or even how its members are going to be chosen, none of that fundamentally matters to him. It's the vibe of the thing. And Leeser is now happy to sign Labor's blank cheque.
And I will support the referendum being put this year.
So, what should that teach Peter Dutton and his team? This. It's their details argument won't work if even Julian Leeser has now jumped ship after making that argument himself, designing that argument. It's the vibe. It's this crusading feeling. And I don't discount the possibility that for Leeser, among others, it'll now be a huge relief to have himself praised today as a great man, an angel. I mean, Teal independents were praising him all day, a man of conscience. Even Labor has praised him, a man of strength and principle, which is a huge change after Leeser was last week smeared by the disgusting Noel Pearson, one of the architects of The Voice, as a kind of Nazi, apparently wanting to tattoo Aborigines and put some kind of star maybe on their clothes, like Nazis did to Jews, for being against The Voice.
Because I'm wondering whether Julian expects us to wear a tattoo identifying ourselves as Indigenous. Is that what he's saying? Or that our clothes should be adorned with some kind of badge identifying us as Aboriginal or Torres Strait Islander?
So, appalling person, Pearson. So the Liberals going to learn from this that they cannot fight a moral crusade by just arguing about the details. They have to fight by presenting a competing and compelling moral vision of their own. Their no case is really about treating Australians as equals, not dividing them forever by race, as Albanese wants with his voice. This is really about keeping this Australian egalitarian society, this famously egalitarian society, and not building a new tribal one where your race determines your political rights. Now, I'm told that Peter Dutton, opposition leader, he now gets that. He's gone softly until now, just arguing about the details to keep his party together. But obviously with Leeser now, that's blown up in his face. And now I'm told secondhand though, he'll fight on principle. But he wasn't doing that today. You know, instead he was first praising Leeser and then going back to that details argument that Leeser has just smashed.
He's a person that has our country's best interests at heart. And as he pointed out, he doesn't leave with rancour, he doesn't leave with bitterness. He has gone through a process within our party, and his position is at odds with the overwhelming majority of the Liberal Party members in our party room. I know that people are motivated by sort of a feel-good or a vibe. I understand that, but you need to dig a bit deeper and look at what it is that's being proposed here. It's allowing a national voice that's appointed, not elected, to essentially be another arm of the government, to scrutinise, to lobby, to influence every decision of government. Now think about that for a second. Is that in our country's best interests?
No, it most certainly is not. But that argument didn't stop Leeser. So it's time for a better one, because if the Liberals lose this referendum, I tell you, they are toast. So go all in now. And the argument has to be, The Voice is immoral. It's divisive, dividing us by race. And that's against the culture that created this great country, where people are judged not by their race, or by their ethnicity, or by their colour, or by their religion, but by their character.